So owning a business is extremely hard. So one of the main things that I wanted to touch on during this Black History Month docuseries was how are our Black-owned business restaurant peers doing? And how can we help support them?
I'm really hoping to have the first national Black-owned chain from the beginning to the end. We try to be that midday getaway, because one thing we do know is not too many people like their jobs. So when you come in here for lunch, you have that one little time, that little midday vacation where you don't have to worry about anything, just enjoy your food, listen to the great music that's getting played, and eat your food and go. And my mom actually always wanted to own a restaurant, and then she just went straight for it. We put everything we had together and we really made something that was great. I mean, we've been open now 6 years. We've done Hillary Clinton, Pete Buttigieg, Stacey Abrams, Charles Barkley, Anthony Hamilton. It's about, as the sign above me it says, it's about faith, family, and friendship. My dad quit his corporate job when I was 12, and he started his own programming business, and he was a consultant. We saw my dad go from working every day to being an actual entrepreneur, which gave us even the sight. Because sometimes with people, you have to see it happen for it to really comprehend that it happens. Man, all you have to do is have good work ethic, determination, and a good support system, and you can do it too.
So one of the things that I love about the South is that it's all one particular region, but if you drive 20 to 30 minutes in any given direction, you're bound to find some different kind of cuisine that hasn't piqued your interest yet.
Well, we like to kind of call it soul food breakfast. Yeah, because and our slogan is just like grandma used to make. We came up with that slogan based on the fact that grandma didn't have no pre-cooked food, grandma didn't have a microwave. We don't have any pre-cooked food, and we don't have a microwave in the building. Well, fortunately for me, my family has been in business in Memphis, Tennessee for over the last 45 years. My father and his brothers were the owners of Chisholm Trail Supermarket, which at one time was known as the biggest Black-owned chain of supermarkets in the United States.
In the whole entire...
Yeah, we had like between, I think it was 5 or 7 supermarkets. And it gave me an opportunity to kind of, you know, get in the food business, know what quality food is all about. And I was able to use that to do what I'm doing today. Well, what I would tell anybody to do is get your prayer life first. Yes. And don't be afraid. You know what I mean? Don't be afraid of the unknown. We can't predict what's going to happen tomorrow. But realize that in my case, I just tell you, it's all God. God gives what you call opportunities. God don't give lottery tickets. So he gives you opportunity, but you got to work that opportunity. And I encourage you to realize that whatever you're going to do, it's going to take a lot of hard work and a lot of dedication and ability to stay focused. And you can achieve anything that you want.